In this self-portrait painting time-lapse, I will show you how I started this oil painting with paint and brush without using drawing transfers or pencil drawings on a canvas that has been pre-painted a bright orange. And I will answer your questions about my process, choice of material, subject color, and the use of underpainting colors. So let's get started. The first question is, how do you decide on your subject matter? So thank you for that question. In terms of subject matter, in a very broad terms, I mostly paint portraits. So people are often my subject matter. My recent focus is on creating my tarot series of oil paintings, in which I am creating tarot card images with oil paint. So in this particular series, every tarot card is hand painted on a cradle birch panel. And so therefore the subjects in those images are all people and with the theme of each card. And of these people, many are friends or people that I actually know from either real life or from the online space. And I am not a person that expresses or shares my emotions very much, and my emotions are very much hidden from others, and I deal with them on my own. So through my paintings, I experience my emotions more deeply, and also through them, I express how I feel. And tarot, therefore, to me, it is like the whole spectrum of human experience, emotion, evolution, and growth in a deck of 78 cards. I think that's why I love creating them so much, because it's like I get to live, feel, and express those experiences through each and every card that I create. So self-portrait also enables me to dig into what I'm feeling and then pull that out onto the canvas. The second question is, does your subject matter influence what medium you use? So my main mediums are oil paint and oil pastels. And you can find my videos and tutorials on both on my YouTube channel. So to answer the question, it is not really my subject matter that directly influence my choice of medium, but rather I think it's the project itself. For example, I am currently working on two tarot decks, and one of those you can already see some of the images that I've already painted on my Instagram, and those are all painted with oil paints. And there's the other deck that I'm working on with a friend is a secret project, right? So this secret project, I can't tell you anything about at this stage, but this deck is created exclusively with oil pastels. And the reason for that is that I would like to have a consistent style in one deck. So that's why one deck is all oil paint and painted with a very similar consistent technique, and the other are all oil pastels. However, the size of my painting surface can really influence the way or the technique that I employ to execute that painting. For example, this self-portrait painting that you're watching here, is the size is about 20 inches by 16 inches, which, you know, and it's painting just for the bust up. It's not a full figure, but just like half a figure. So it is not small. It is not too small. In comparison, the tarot paintings I'm working on are about 8 inches by 12 inches, which is quite smaller. So on the smaller size paintings, there is not much room for error, because every little measurement or mismeasurement is proportionally much more significant. So as I want to capture the model's likeness and also hopefully some of the essence that make the painting feel like them, for those smaller paintings, I would conceptualize the piece, what goes in, what symbols to use, and then directly transfer my drawings onto the painting surface and use a painting method that is more carefully rendered. So even with a self-portrait that I painted, the Three of Swords, for my tarot series, I use the same method, which is I have a drawing first to make sure that the proportion of the model's features are correct before I go in and start putting on paint. So you can also take a peek at my process of creating the Queen of Cups with a real model, Sasha Graham, by clicking the icon on the top right corner. So however, when it comes to this larger piece, because of the larger size, there's much more room for error and correction. And I would then start with just a brush and some diluted paint to draw or sketch the feature, the figure directly on canvas without doing the drawing first. So because then I can wipe off the paint, the errors, and push the edges to manipulate the shapes and to achieve the likeness as I go. The third question is, what paint do you use? So I use mostly Gamblin's oil paint products. They're oil paints as well as they are painting mediums. And I have an intro to oil painting series of videos here on the YouTube channel, and where I introduce the materials that I use. And you can take a look here by clicking the card on the screen. The next question is, how do you make paint transparent? So some colors are just inherently transparent colors, such as viridian, magenta, ultramarine blue, transparent oxide red, transparent oxide yellow. Basically, usually the darker colors are transparent colors. And the labels on the paint tubes most likely would tell you whether the color is transparent, semi-transparent, opaque, or semi-opaque. So that's one way you can tell. And to make your paint, if you would like to have your paint more transparent, one way is just to simply use transparent or semi-transparent colors. Now, but you can make any colors, even opaque colors, more transparent by, I find mostly maybe by two main methods. So the first method is to simply using a dry brush to really push that in and spread the paint out very thinly. So you might like to use a bristle brush for that method because it allows you to push the paint, like really spread the paint out thinly. So that's more like a dry brushing technique, or called scumbling technique, where you use dry paint to spread it out. And basically that method also relies on the painting surface, like your cotton canvas probably will work better with the dry brushing or scumbling technique than a very smooth wood panel. That is because when you are dry brushing, you are relying on the texture of the painting surface when you spreading that paint, like the dips of the surface will be left out, not catching the paint, and the texture where the, you know, the surface material kind of pops out a little bit will catch the paint. So that is a bit more reliant on the surface of your painting material. And the second method that you can make your paint more transparent is called glazing. Basically, what it means is that you add painting medium to your paint colors. You can add linseed oil, glycerin, and basically the more medium you add, the more transparent your paint becomes. And when you do that with the glazing method, sometimes you need to wait for your existing layer of paint to dry before you apply the transparent glaze over it. Otherwise, you might risk wiping off or rubbing off your existing layer of paint if that paint is still wet. Do you know there is also a white that is transparent, that's zinc white? So towards the end of the painting, I decided that I wanted the background to be more lighten it up to be white, but I don't want to cover it to be entirely just an opaque white. And I want to maintain some of the patterns and colors that's to let the orange peek through. So instead of going it in with opaque white, like titanium white, I use zinc white. So just stay to the end of the video, you can see how I then use the transparent white color to paint over the background to lighten it up, but also let the underpainting peek through. The next question is, how do you select your underpainting color? Why do you start with orange? So as you know, you can paint from a blank white canvas, you can paint from a wood panel that has the natural wood color, or you can tone your painting surface with neutral colors like gray or amber, or you can underpaint your painting surface with any color you like the one that you're watching here is bright orange. So how do I decide? So before I go into the method on how do you choose, I just want to say for this particular painting, I didn't have the subject matter first and then strategize or analyze what color I use. So for this particular painting, basically before I started painting, it was a blank canvas and I just have leftover paint of cadmium yellows and cadmium reds from another painting. Because as you know, the cadmiums are the more expensive colors and I don't want to waste them, and then I just use them on a blank canvas and painted it bright orange, and I just figured that one day I would use that canvas for some painting, right? So I know that this answer for this particular painting is not very helpful, so I'm gonna talk about some ways, some ideas that might be helpful when choosing or deciding what underpainting colors to use. So if you already have some subject matter in mind, okay, so this is different than when you're just painting intuitively, you don't have to worry about that. But if you already have a subject matter in mind and you want to select an underpainting color that's suitable, then you can start thinking about like what kind of feelings do you want your final piece to feel like. If you want your final painting to feel more warm and have that more of a vitality and have more passionate kind of feeling to it, then choose a bright warm color like the orange that I used here. And if you want your final painting to feel more calm and peaceful, then choose a more cooler colors, more calm kind of colors like blue or green or like a light mint, you know, that kind of things. So you also want to make sure that your underpainting is really completely dry before you paint over it, especially you have these bright colors as your underpainting. And if you are unsure, a neutral tone like a gray or amber is always a good choice because you can easily paint over them and they don't affect the final piece, the overall feel of the final piece, like a bright orange does in here. So that's all of the questions that I've got from you so far. And I would really like to be able to answer more of your questions. So if you enjoyed this video, please give me a like and subscribe to my channel and share the video. And also, if you have any questions about my process, my creative life, you know, or any question in general, just leave, send me a message or leave a comment and I will answer them in my next videos. If you enjoy my content, I have a free PDF art and tarot lesson for you to download for free. It will help you find your true north and free your creative spirit by embodying the star card in the tarot that you create for yourself. You can download it by going to my website. The link is on the screen as well as in the description below. So also click the like button and share this video. It will help my channel grow and I really, really appreciate that. Thank you and see you next time.